We are a very healthy, non-romantic relationship. We work out our issues pretty seamlessly.
Well, I'm ready to spend my whole life with Lennon. I'll say that right now on Young Hollywood.
This is a perfect relationship, so give me the kid.
Why do you need more time?
What's up, guys? Nikki Novak here in the Young Hollywood studio with BFFs Jessica St. Clair and Lennon Parham. Are you used to being introduced like that?
We are, and we love it.
The weirdest thing is, you know, like the little abbreviations for things that people text all the time now?
Yes.
I always thought, and I'm going to swear, Young Hollywood, BFFs meant best friends.
Interesting.
I really did.
You did.
So when young girls would wear those BFF
you
things.
You thought it was very
I
rude.
Thought they were, I did.
That's amazing.
I mean, in America, we go wild real young.
Yeah, we do.
You do.
It's better than best fat friends. You know what I mean? Or something horrible like that. I'd rather be called best friends. I'm saying, you know?
So when did you two first meet? I heard you met.
We met 10 years ago at the Upright Citizens Brigade Theater in New York. And that was back when there were not very many women at the theater. So I remember seeing Lennon across a crowded room and I believe you were wearing an Express cardigan. I was probably in a pair of capri pants.
Yeah.
I thought that was awesome. And I thought to myself, like, oh, what's that nice girl doing underground in this
dirty basement
doing comedy and saying horrible things on stage?
Nice girls don't do that.
So I thought there must be something terribly wrong with her, like me.
She was right.
And I was right. And we became fast friends. And then 4 years ago, we started writing together. And then that's when our love really solidified. We are a very healthy, non-romantic relationship. We work out our issues pretty seamlessly.
Well, I'm ready to spend my whole life with Lennon. I'll say that right now on Young Hollywood.
This is a perfect relationship, so give me the kid.
Why do you need more time?
I'm too much for you. I wear her out. That's true.
You're a lot to handle.
I am a lot.
So the show, I've heard that you guys said that men, like some of the men, when they saw it, they're kind of shocked because they're surprised at how women actually talk behind the scenes.
Yes.
Yeah, when we had our first table read for the show,
some of our friends who were there were like, oh, this is what you're like. Because I think we all present ourselves to the world in a certain light. Like, it's important as a woman to appear like you have your together when none of us do. And the more you talk to women, you're like, oh, everything's falling apart. I got my period during that scene. Whatever it is. Like,
right.
You know, you don't have it together. And guys, when they get to see behind that layer of the facade,
they love
it blows their mind.
What is like the one thing that stands out? Because I know there's things that my friends and I say behind the scenes that guys have no
horrible
clue.
Things.
Like we have, my friends and I have this thing where we rate guys by number of yogurts.
Why is it
sort of hot? Because you'll see, because in casual conversation when there's other men at the table, you could say, how many yogurts did you have today?
Oh, that's fantastic.
And you say the number and they have no clue. They think you're on a diet.
Oh, that's lovely.
Oh, we will be stealing all of that. Don't worry.
And we so have wait, a, what is it? Four is the hottest?
Four is just beyond hot.
And
if they get
is,
one yogurt, and if you say you didn't have any yogurts,
oh,
you might as well leave the table.
But what if you said I'm lactose intolerant? That means that person is
that's a whole new, I never thought
yeah,
of that
think
one.
About it.
So I have a little game for you guys.
Yes, please.
The Newlywed Game. Did you ever watch The Newlywed Game?
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Where it's how well you know your newlywed, but in this case, it'll be how well do you know your BFF? First, I'm gonna ask Jessica.
Yes.
What is Lennon's favorite ice cream?
Hold on one second. Hold on, I just have to go through a couple processes here.
I want you to think hard about Helen.
Okay, time's up.
I gave you a clue.
Reveal.
Coffee.
Yes!
You did it!
Did you guys,
she gave me a secret clue. She gave me a secret clue.
So next question,
got
Jessica.
It.
Yes.
What is Lennon's middle name?
This isn't
you
right.
You better know this.
This isn't
you
right.
You do know it, you know it.
And reveal.
Trust yourself. Kathleen.
Kathleen.
Thank yes!
God. You know, I've now, your show middle name has become, in my mind, what
yeah,
your real middle
we
name is.
Yeah, called Lennon and Jessica on the show,
yeah.
too, since we wrote it.
Yes.
And the last question,
yes.
Lennon. Is Jessica Team Twilight or Team Hunger Games?
Both of them scare me. Just so you know, I'm scared by both of these
movies. I'm doing an off the grid answer.
You can go off the grid.
Okay, you're gonna
and
be
reveal.
Wrong.
You're gonna lie.
You can't collaborate. Are you ready?
Yeah, okay,
yes.
Ready.
Go.
Neither, she's Anne of Green Gables.
That's true.
I love
true.
It.
Okay, Amy Poehler was in here, who I know you both love and worked with.
Yes.
Described herself with one word and described herself as juicy. Describe each other with one word.
Okay.
Ready?
Don't say ugly. Okay.
She would never reveal.
No. Vibrant.
Funny. I said funny.
Oh, well, they're not the same, but this is why you're BFF.
Funny.
And because you're such good sports.
Oh hey. My God, I love it.
Young Hollywood.
I like
hats.
It.
Oh my God. I'm wearing.
It's
wear
pre-worn.
This is very cute. Thank you.
Do not look good in
did
a
you
hat.
Know they simultaneously put it on at the same time? Oh. It was like.
Lennon wears a hat better than me, though. Right?
So you were driving. I'm gonna.